In this video, I'm going to show you how to assess regional and segmental intervertebral motion of the mid-cervical spine in extension and sitting position. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Passive assessment of the quantity and quality of segmental intervertebral motion, also known as motion palpation, is part of the diagnostic clinical expertise of manual practitioners to guide decisions on a therapeutic strategy for patients with spinal pain. Hypomobility indicates mobilizing interventions, while hypermobility calls for a stabilizing approach. A systematic review done by Van Treifel et al. In the year 2005 evaluated the reliability of passive segmental assessment of the cervical spine and found an overall reliability of poor to fair. For this reason, the clinical value of passive mid-cervical spine assessment is rather weak. In order to perform regional range of motion assessment for mid-cervical spine extension of vertebrae C2 till C7, have your patient sit upright at the edge of the bench or on a stool while the examiner stands posterior laterally on the side to be examined. The bench height should be adjusted so that your patient's head is at the same height as your sternum. First, fixate the spinous process of C2 with one hand and rotate the upper cervical spine via the patient's occiput towards the side to be tested until you feel resistance. The upper cervical spine is brought into slight flexion via the patient's occiput and fixated in this position between your chest and working hand. Then, fixate your patient's vertebrae C7 with your other hand with a key grip into ventrocranial direction. Now perform a maximal homonymous 3D movement with equal components of extension, ipsilateral lateral flexion, and ipsilateral rotation. This movement causes maximal compression of the facet joints of C2 till C7 on the ipsilateral side. The whole movement is judged on resistance during motion and at end range, range of motion, as well as possible pain provocation compared to the other side. In order to continue with segmental assessment, have your patient sit straight again and first rotate the upper cervical spine until you feel resistance. Bring the upper cervical spine into slight flexion again via the patient's occiput. To test segments C2, C3, your fixating hand is now placed on C3 with a key grip into ventrocranial direction, while your working hand remains on the patient's occiput. If you don't feel like your hands are colliding, you may also want to choose to move the working hand onto the upper segment, in this case C2 if you prefer. Then perform a maximal homonymous 3D movement with equal components of extension, ipsilateral lateral flexion, and ipsilateral rotation again. To test each component of intervertebral motion, slightly move out of the end range, and now test extension between C2 and C3 by pushing the spinous process of C3 ventrocranially with your fixating hand. To assess rotation, keep your fixation on C3 and rotate further via the occiput or push the ipsilateral arch of C3 ventrally with your thumb. And for the lateral flexion component, keep C3 fixated and move C2 laterally with your working hand. Each component is judged on resistance during motion and feel, as well as possible pain provocation compared to the segment above or below. In order to test the lower segments, move your fixating hand down onto C4 with your working hand staying on the occiput or moving to the contralateral arch of C3. And now perform a 3D extension movement and continue this way until you reach C7 with your fixating hand. Alright, this is our video on intervertebral motion assessment of the mid-cervical spine in extension in sitting position. If you want to learn how to assess intervertebral motion of the mid-cervical spine in extension in supine position, click on the video right next to me. At last, thank you very much for watching. Feel free to give this video a like if it was helpful to you and share it. Click on the subscribe button and the little bell icon next to it in order not to miss any future videos. This was Kai for Physiotutors. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.